Hey, spiritual superstar. So let me just tell you, if you're trying to hesitate and doing what you got to do in your calling, your purpose, your mission, because you think you got to get it all perfect and you've got to be all this and that, and you got to get this camera, you got to get this lighting and all of that, that's not it. You just need to go on out there and serve in your mission. Let me share a story with you, okay? I'm Nicole, founder of Spiritual Guidance Academy, where we help you master your spiritual gifts. We help you live an improved life. We'll help you with an improved, healthy lifestyle, the whole nine yards, okay? We still trying to figure out how to put that in one big mission, but we help you do it. Now, I wouldn't even be doing this unless I took that leap of faith, and I hesitated for years. Matter of fact, I knew that I should have been in my calling when I was going through my Saturn return from really 25 up to 31. I knew it. 27 hit. I definitely knew that I needed to be on purpose in spiritual guidance. I didn't know what to call it then. I knew that I was psychic. I knew that I was hearing messages all over the place. I knew that things were happening that I was prophesizing, and I was scared. So I hesitated. And if what I share with you right now can help you at all, hit that thumbs up button, comment down below, and share your testimony just so that you can get it out. The universe will grab it, reverse it, and bring it back to you in your manifested outcome, okay? That's how the law of attraction works, but you got to put it out there for the universe to grab it, reverse it, throw it back to you in your success. All right? So I remember I was like, I can't get out there, you know. I'm not an expert at anything. I was so hard on myself. I was down on myself. I was comparing myself to everybody that was already out here that didn't even look like me, weren't even doing spiritual guidance, you know, and that were totally in a different focus in spirituality, in health and wellness, in mindset, in all of these arenas that I'm in now. And I would say, you know, look at Gabby Bernstein, you know, she's got her stuff together, and, you know, maybe I need to model after her. Maybe I need to try to read up on her and research her and try to mimic her, basically. No, not at all, not at all, not at all. And then I was like, well, you know, I think that people are going to be looking at me like, you know, well, who is she? What does she have to offer? Let me tell you something. If you're looking at yourself like that, you got everything to offer. You don't have to be another Gabby Bernstein. You don't have to be another Lisa Nichols. You do not have to be another Nicole Livingston. You do have to be yourself. You do have to get out there and serve the masses like only you can. But here's the other part, is you will get overwhelmed if you think that you have to do it all by yourself. You do not. You do not have to do it alone. And I think, in particular, people that have never been in that position to truly give to others without exhausting ourselves, right? We're givers, but without exhausting ourselves, without depleting our resources. Those that are givers, when you don't even have abundance yourself, real abundance, meaning if you had to buy a flight just tomorrow, just right now, if you had to go get a flight, it's going to cost you a couple grand. If you had to do that and be somewhere for an indefinite amount of time, would you have the money to do it? The hotel, rental car, your living expenses, just getting on the plane, so you got to go buy clothes wherever you get to. Things like that. If you're a giver and you're giving of yourself to the point of your exhaustion and your depletion, then I feel like it's even more difficult for you to come out and just be true to what Spirit is telling you to do. And that's what we have to do. That's what you have to bring to the platform. You have to bring that to your audience. So there is no buying a $400 camera that I bought that didn't even work. Still to this day, and I can't return it because I bought it during Mercury retrograde. Mercury is my ruling planet, and I knew better. Okay? Knew better. Actually, that thing cost $700. Knew better. Okay? And it cuts off after 15 minutes. Knew better. Because I was fine using my laptop. So now, I just use my MacBook. I was using a Dell then. Got a MacBook. Started using that. That's it. Why can't we use our phone? You know you can, right? So, we go through this thing of, okay, well, I need this, I need that. You know, someone had a green screen. Nadia Shaw had a green screen. Then I saw, what's her name? Kelly Serrano? I can't think of her last name. She had Rosano. She had a green screen at some point. Doreen Virtue had a green screen. I want a green screen. I want that too. It was so cool. Did I need it? No, I didn't need it. But I wanted it. But you know what I ended up doing? I paused my creative expression until I got that green screen. And then you know what happened? It caused so much more complication to what I was doing when all Spirit was telling me to do was to deliver the message. That's it. Forget about all the fanciness. Forget about all of the rhinestone. Forget about having to have a made-up face. Your hair is all together. That does not matter all the time. Sometimes it's going to matter depending on what content you're putting out there, right? It depends sometimes. Not all the time. When you're focusing more on that than your message, that's a mistake. That's what I did. Oh my gosh, did I ever. And when I first came out, very first, before I even knew that I was supposed to be charging for readings, before I even knew that, you know, that I would be received by you so lovely and so fast, before I even knew that why I was out there opening a YouTube channel was to welcome people in and to be welcomed into their journey. Before I even knew I had 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000 subscribers and it was growing, I did a reading for somebody, woke up the night before, and Archangel Raphael called my name and made me say negative. Negative. And I knew then that it was going to be somebody the following day that had scheduled a reading that was going to try to say what I said wasn't the truth, was going to try to do something negative, was going to try to leave a negative impression on my reputation. There was going to be something. She wasn't going to like a reading, or he wasn't going to like the reading. And I asked Archangel Raphael, is there something I should do right now? And Archangel Raphael was like, nope. All you need to do is be ready. That reading taught me to always have a reading after I'm grounded. Always come into a reading grounded and spiritually protected. Okay? During the reading, be spiritually protected. After the meeting, be spiritually protected. Because the things that came from Spirit for this one client was so right on point that she was freaked out, completely scared, and totally out of her integrity. And when I realized that point, it was only at I asked her to put her camera on because I had mine on. And I was very, very new in it, right? Very new. This was like maybe the fourth reading that I had done. And openly, I mean, you know, on my, after I came to you on my channel. And she didn't want to come out on camera, but I could feel her energy. And I wanted to look at her eyes. Man, when I tell you, the second she put her camera on, I jumped. Man, oh man, her energy was so negative. Her energy was so negative. That's the first thing that I felt. I was like, ooh, okay. You know, because we both got our camera on now, so I'm like, ooh. You know, I tried to play it off. You know, I know you can see it all over my face because I was just shook. You know, and so the reading was just, she wasn't going to pay me. She tried to, matter of fact, she did. She pulled her money back. She canceled the payment. That's what she did. She canceled the payment and, she gave me a bad review. And here's the thing. And now my feelings were really hurt because I knew that everything that I was channeling was coming up. She was confirming it. But what I was channeling was not what she wanted. She didn't want that answer that she was getting. She wanted the one that she had already resigned on. This is what I want. And I'm just asking you for confirmation. And so the whole, it was just a battle. It was just a battle. But even though it was a battle, even though her energy was, I mean, straight up negative. It really was. You could just feel it, everything. And I mean, no judgment. This is just really what it was. And so you have to know the difference between healthy energy and negative energy that's going to battle you. But my point is, I would have never experienced that. And I would have never known that, Nikki, you cannot do any more readings unless you are covered. Unless you are doing your spiritual practice, unless you are coming in grounded, you are in that thing grounded, and you are leaving grounded because you got a family to take care of, and you've got you. You use you, the soul, in your job. This is your purpose, and you use you. You don't get any deeper than using your soul. So, okay, I got to be grounded. I got to practice spiritual safety. But I would have never known how deeply I needed to really have that plan of action and how to be grounded unless I went through that naked, okay? Another one was even before that. I think it was the first reading that I ever recorded. I didn't know what I was doing. I just knew that, you know, this is what Spirit was saying. You need to offer them a recording, okay? Well, I was doing readings back to back. And I didn't have my hair. My hair was looking crazy. When I tell you, I think I had just taken out a sew-in. And my hair was literally, I mean, I had just done under the braids and everything. My hair was like, shh, right? Well, I'm not going to be on camera for this one. I'm just videotaping the whole, you know, the reading. So I'm good. Plus, you know, when you're behind the scenes, you're all, oh my gosh, if your scalp, if you're itching and all that stuff, you know what the deal is, right? I didn't know how to edit the video, and I didn't know how to stop it because I had to yell at the kids before I realized I was still recording. So how am I going to, you know, how am I going to edit that? And then I had turned the camera around so that she's looking at me. Well, I'm like telling the kids, be quiet. I just got done with the reading. Man, I wanted to be on time with the reading. I wanted to be on time with giving her her video. I just sent it like that because I didn't know how to cut it out. I don't know if she ever asked for another reading again in her life. I don't know. I don't think she did. And, I felt so bad about that forever. But then, you know what that prompted me to do? Go to my technology friends. you know, my technology expert friends. I need some editing software. What can I do? They hooked me up. They gave me some free editing software. I couldn't tell you what the name of it was, but it worked. Boom. I was like, okay, now I know what to do. So my point is this. You will learn as you go, but don't ever hesitate in getting out there. You got to serve your mission. You got to help these people. You got to do what you got to do so that Spirit can make it do what it do through you. All right. I pray to God that this has helped you. If it has, please comment down below. Hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe. And come on back for more spiritual guidance. All right. Hey, don't forget, you got a special going on. We'll put it down below, okay? I expect to see you soon. Mwah. Love you. Look at that, 1555.